I'm not afraid.
You will be. You will be.
Star Wars Rebels episode 10. We are back for the mid-season finale. Great to have Star Wars Rebels back. I mean, what a great way to start off as well for 2015 for Star Wars Rebels. It was a great episode. At first, I thought it was going to be an enjoyable episode, but it really took it to high gear. Excuse me. Towards the end of this episode, I mean, whoo! Now there's going to be spoilers, so if you don't want to be spoiled, please go watch my other videos. But if you do want to be spoiled, I'm assuming you saw the episode. I'm just my thoughts on the episode, and my thoughts are, God damn, dude! I hope that in Star Wars Episode 7, there's a little bit, you know, a little cameos of everything that this world is bringing. Because everything that this world is doing, the show is doing, really captures that nostalgia, that feeling of the old Star Wars we used to love. The music in today's episode was fantastic. It fit the mood so well, especially that we're now seeing Ezra go to the path of Jedi. I mean, this is a huge development for Ezra in this episode, and a huge development for Kanan as well as a master to his Padawan. Now, to complete Ezra's training, Kanan tells Ezra, you need the Force to guide you towards this temple, a Jedi temple, and we'll go to the Jedi temple and you will begin your training. We will see if you really are going to become a Jedi or not. So we see Ezra go to one of the, he uses the Force, they go to a Jedi temple, which is a big ass boulder, like a big ass rock surrounded by little mini rocks, and really give you an imagination, think of Avatar when they're in Pandora, you know, they're flying over and you see a bunch of fog and you see a bunch of these mountains and rock. It's like that, but you know, they're on ground. What was really cool, what I loved about that Jedi temple was they both had the rock was telling them, the temple was telling Ezra that they wanted not only Ezra but also Kanan. They wanted them to, you know, work together to find an entrance to this Jedi temple because there was no entrance. And you just see these two use the Force, and it's just a great shot seeing these two together, and you can really just see the camaraderie from episode one to now, that Kanan is truly, you know, he truly deeply cares about Ezra, and he doesn't want to fail Ezra, as because there's some hints of the past of Kanan, and he might have done something wrong. He might have went to the dark side at one point. He might have abandoned, maybe just fled when the Jedis were being executed. There's something in Kanan's past that he doesn't want to fail Ezra. He thinks Ezra could become a great, powerful Jedi warrior. But it's like a counter, because Ezra doesn't want to fail Kanan as well. Ezra has some dark, you know, feelings inside of him where he wants revenge. He wants to never be alone. He wants to protect the ones he loves. So he needs to overcome that and really just let go. Really embrace what's surrounding him right now and not focus on revenge. So it was great to see these two go into the temple. And you see all these old Jedis, you know, that are dead. And Ezra's just like freaking out because all these old masters are just surrounded, kind of dead, their bones and stuff. And then Ezra has to go at it alone. And he goes into this little tunnel, and the tunnel closes up, and Kanan waits for him. And you see the Luke Skywalker training session. You see when Luke Skywalker was with Yoda on the planet, and Luke went out into the forest, and he had to pretty much face his own fears. There's that little battle with him and Darth Vader, and then he cuts off Darth Vader's head, and it's actually his face reflecting Darth Vader. This is Ezra. This is Ezra going into, like, you know, getting those same situations. He thinks Kanan came along, and Kanan's fighting the Inquisitor. Inquisitor kills Kanan. Ezra is, you know, pissed. You know, you see the rage that's coming before him. You see him fall, fall over the cliff. You see, Ezra, like, in different situations, you see him on the Ghost Cruise ship and them talking bad to Ezra, not wanting, saying that they only, like, is using them. Excuse me. You see Ezra in different situations, and you always see the Inquisitor really just chasing after him, really going after him. And Ezra's losing his mind, but then he realizes this is just an illusion. He's not afraid anymore, and then he finally puts his foot down and really challenges this Inquisitor as an Inquisitor, like, strikes him, but he doesn't strike him. It's just an illusion. So Ezra passes that test to he's not afraid. Now, badass moment of the episode. This is what really brought it to awesome level, and that was Yoda's voice. You could hear Yoda's voice in the temple telling Ezra, you know, what do you seek, Jedi? You seek, you know, really showing Ezra the way to where to go. And not only talking to Ezra, but also talking to Kanan and telling Kanan, what are you afraid of yourself? What is troubling you? And that's when we hear Kanan's troubling, doesn't want to fail Ezra, doesn't want Ezra to go to the dark side. And it was just great to hear Yoda's voice. I mean, Yoda is the king of all Jedi Masters. I think if you had to rank Jedi Masters, Yoda has to be number one. He's such a little guy and such a little badass. When I think of Yoda, I don't think too much of the prequels. I think of him in the four, when Luke first meets him and how wise he is, and he doesn't rely on the lightsaber, he relies on the Force. He brings up the X-Wing from the swamp. I remember that Yoda. That Yoda was very powerful. Now, you got to also remember Yoda's voiceover in this episode. This doesn't necessarily mean he's dead. This is not after, you know, episode 6 of the film franchise. This is before, this is between New Hope and also Revenge of the Sith. So it's right in the middle. So I think when you heard Yoda's voice speaking to Ezra and speaking to Kanan, and you don't see Yoda, because if he was dead, you would see his ghost figure, and that would imply that this is way after all the after Luke and Rebels won. But of course, this is not. So I think Yoda was on his planet, and really he could sense that these two Jedis were in this temple and really communicated with them telepathically. So that's why we get this voiceover of Yoda, and why it makes sense that you don't see the ghost, the spirit ghost. So to confirm, Yoda is not dead. He's very much alive. He probably sensed Kanan and Ezra entering this temple, and he used his telepathic powers, I guess, to really just get to the Force and go to Kanan and Ezra and show Ezra the way. So don't worry. This is not after, you know, episode 6 if you're confused. This is still before New Hope and Luke Skywalker's story and the end of episode 3, Revenge of the Sith. God, it was just such a great episode. And it was the capping moment with Ezra finally getting a crystal, one of those crystals to build his lightsaber, was awesome. I would have liked it to be a different color, but I think I know it's different kind of, every color means something. I don't know if having a different color lightsaber, like a green one, is like kind of an upgrade to the blue one. Not sure about that. But yes, it was cool to see him. He got the blue one, of course. He made his own lightsaber by the help of all his crew. All his crew chipped in, you know, to make his own lightsaber, which is kind of like a staple gun, honestly. It has a little, like, kind of like a little... So this is, like, imagine me holding a staple gun and there's, like, a little hole right here. Like, it looks like it shoots out something. And we remember you heard Sabine say that she gave him some, like, kind of explosions, like some stuff. So I'm pretty sure it does more than just the lightsaber. It probably shoots out crap. That's what I was thinking. But it really looks like a staple gun, honestly. And then you see the light, the laser come out of it. Not too big of a fan of his lightsaber. It was okay. We'll see how it works during the series. But it's great to see Ezra finally get his lightsaber, because I think during the first half, we're just waiting for him to get the lightsaber, waiting for him to really, you know, use that thing with Kanan. So now that he's got it, it was a great wait. And it was a great episode to showcase his maturity, he's not too mature, but, you know, his path, his journey from where he was to where he is now. He still has a lot to learn. He's still a little bit too immature, where I'm like, what the fuck, Ezra? Just listen to your master. Stop smart-assing, whatever. We'll see if he will mature more towards the series. I believe so. I think the creators are doing a wonderful job with these characters. It was really Ezra and Kanan's episode. you saw the Ghost Crew a little bit, but that's fine. That's fine because we want to see Ezra. He's the main character. We want to see him progress, and he progressed in such a huge way in this episode. And it was great to hear Yoda really, you know, telling him, you know, showing him the path of the Jedi as well, because Yoda is one of the last remaining big founders of the Jedi Council. So it was such a great way to see. This makes me want to just see Episode 7 even more. So it's good that we have Star Wars Rebels to really just, you know, that we're addicted, and that's keeping us, you know, I don't want to keep us high, but it's keeping us at bay until we get Episode 7. So can't wait to see what they do with the rest of the series. I think next weekend we get Chopper. Chopper's episode. I don't know about that one, but we'll see if it's going to be, it's definitely going to be lighthearted. But cannot wait to see more of what they do for this series. It was great. Give it a 10 out of 10. This episode really, it was started off just, I enjoyed it a lot towards the beginning, but really took it to high gear at the end of this episode. It really had that tonal shift a little bit. Music was played beautifully in here. Animation was great. The fight scenes were fantastic. The mythology was great as well. Everything you want in a Star Wars episode. The characters are blossoming really well, and they're really well done. So thank you guys for listening. If you liked this video, please push the like button and please subscribe for more. Sorry, like I said, I'm a little bit sick, so I'm bringing you videos though. We got all our shows are coming back. So that's another edition of Star Wars Rebels. Let me know what you guys thought about the episode. Did you think this was definitely a home run to start off the 2015 for Star Wars, or did you not really dig the episode? Let me know. I just want to know your guys' thoughts on the episode. I'm just freaking out. Just great episode. Great Yoda cameo. So thanks, guys.